you saying something? Uh-uh, you can't tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Uh-uh, you can't tell me nothing.
La, 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 la. Wait till I get my money right. La, 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 la. Then you can't tell me nothing.
5 or 10 minutes, shoot a little bit of something around with us. Also, we're going to talk about Trump, we're going to talk about Russia, talk about a whole bunch of good stuff. So stay tuned, we'll be right back. Never give up, right? Mr. Anthony Biscotti's here with me. Once again, this is Life Camera Action. My name is Jason McDermott. You know, you can reach us at 102.3 FM, 106.5 FM. Also, we got 1050 AM. Let's not forget, hey, we want you to call us to call, okay? So 909-888-5222. We also got 888-909-1050 for the web guys, right?
It's for the web. It's www.kcaaradio.com.
And then what you do is you go to Life Camera Action. Click on it. There we are.
And the cool thing about it is you get to see what we look like, for one. And then you get to also see behind the scenes of what radio is kind of all about.
Yeah, exactly. And you know what? Let's say you want us to wear something nice, okay? You just go ahead and you tell us what's going on. You know, we're definitely proactive with all this.
Yes, we are. And we have a closet in the back, and we just get any kind of clothes at any given time, and we get, you know, put on whatever we want.
Yep. And then you see these hot Miss Pauline is in the house as well, ladies and gentlemen. So let's give it up for her.
Miss Pauline. Yes, Pauline, right?
Yeah. Pauline, Anthony Biscotti, Pauline, he's going to sit here with us for a little bit. We're going to talk about cheating and what you can expect to look for. So we'd always love a woman's point of view because, you know, usually it's us that does the messing up.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. But see, what I want to do first is this. See, I got a new book that came out, okay? And it's called I Am, all right? So I don't know if you're on the webcast or whatever, but if you are, take a look. Bam, there it is. You can actually... check me out. Go to my, you know, Gmail, mjm92375@gmail.com. So that's mjm92375, basically September 23rd, 1975, @gmail.com.
That's
pretty
right.
Good at that, huh? So cheating out, we're going to talk about a man and a woman, but I want to read a little bit of something right here. Because one of my little stories here is actually called The Cheater. If you can believe that, you know what I mean? So It goes like this. There's many types of cheating out there, but the one we most equate or associate with would be with the opposite sex. In this next section, I can only speak on events and feelings that I've personally had to experience. Okay? So I realized a long time ago, possibly at the young age of 7, that if you were pretty, flirty, and had a decent body, well, you can get almost anything you want. All right? I mean, we were the most part, when I grew up, we had no money, you know, not too much of that. I noticed my mom's boyfriends, I mean, they'd take us places, you know, buy me toys, sometimes clothes and shoes. I also came to realize that those things I received came with a price, all right? Because towards the end of the night, the only thing I'd see would be the back of that locked closed door.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? So basically, let's review. We learned in step one that if you look good, have a somewhat presentable body, smile and flirt, then comes step two. At the end of the night, you're in a room, locked with that person, doors closed. Then came step number three. Once one and two are complete, you can pretty much have anything you'd like. So I thought, hey, that's it. I mean, that's the secret to getting anything you want. And I need to learn this because, you know what? Most importantly, I need to perfect this because I'm going to be the best at this. You know why? Because to be honest, I'm in no doubt it needs a lot. So, I mean, my idea of cheating, I learned at a real young age that, you know, it's a dangerous situation out there. And when you deal with people's emotions, you take a risk sometimes. What do you think, Pauline? How are you? Let's say hi to Pauline, everybody.
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Say hi to everybody.
Hello, everybody.
There we are. So, you know, I was talking with Mr. Biscotti here. And, you know, I believe you just had a new baby, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Congratulations, my friend.
Thank Congrats. You, my brother.
Absolutely. Boy, girl?
It's a girl.
Awesome. My first – is that your first one, right?
Yeah, my first one.
That's the way to go. My first one was a girl as well. Yeah, I tell you a funny story there. You know, I was so headstrong and, you know, egotistical, you know, male, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, I got to have a boy. So we go to the ultrasound and everything and, you know, they say, oh, it's a girl. And I'm like, wait a minute, what? You know, like, I couldn't believe it. I thought I was willing myself to have a boy no matter what. I even made the lady check twice. She finally goes to my ex-wife. She's like, get this dude out of here, would you? I'm like, all right. And then come to find out, you know, it was the best thing ever that I had a girl.
Daddy's girl.
It was so awesome. You know, so humbling. I mean, it was just the best experience ever. So really definitely very happy about that. Heads up Donna Ray and Mason as well. And Devin. And who else?
Jordan.
Don't forget about
I
her.
Love you.
There it is. What about you? You want to give one out to your little girl?
Nah. Oh, yeah. I give a shout out to Emily's and everybody out there listening right now.
There it is. Tuning in.
So.
That's what I'm talking about. All right, so we're going to talk a little bit about what's going on in politics and all that good stuff in a little bit. But, well, we got my man here. You know, why don't we talk about, do you think everybody cheats?
Well, you know, it's a funny thing you say that because I don't think everybody cheats. I really don't. But I do believe that, you know, the common person that I've seen cheat doesn't go looking for it. They really don't. You know, you could get sent to the liquor store. You could get sent to the market to go buy, you know, a gallon of milk for your wife. And you get there and the clerk starts flirting with you a little bit. She makes you feel a little happy. She's a little young looking and you know, and then that's where it starts. So next thing you know, the following week you're buying milk again. And then there goes the dialogue of, hey, how are you doing, blah, blah, blah. So I don't think people necessarily go – well, some do. But I think a lot of people that do end up cheating, it's not something that they were looking to do. It just happened at work. Somebody started flirting with them. And, you know, I'll tell you right now, my pastor used to say it the best. If you're not holding your wife's hand, someone else is.
Yeah.
And that's the truth. So if you want to go out and play around and do whatever, more than likely she's going to do it too. But my whole thing with that is do I believe everybody cheats? Yes, I do. And either they want to do it or they just fell into it.
Or sometimes the opportunity is actually going to present itself in a bad moment.
Correct.
You know, also, here's the thing. Now, is it a relationship they're building or is it just a one-time thing? Or actually, I tell you what the worst is do they do it on purpose when they see you with your girl?
You know, that, yeah, I do believe that. I do believe that because me as a DJ, when I would go play certain places, I get no play. Mm-hmm. But then I'm there with somebody, and you start getting the girls looking at you. I've had people give me their number, you know, as I'm buying a drink. And there's something about that edge of people just wanting to have that
what you got
adventure that and that adventurous feeling of let me give this guy my number.
Mm-hmm.
So I do really believe that, you know, you got two types of cheaters. You got the one that just wants to cheat, and then you got the one that just falls into it.
Yeah,
you know,
it seems to me, and we'll get Pauline's opinion here in a minute, but. When I'm out with her or something, it's just you get a lot more attention. You get a lot more looks from girls. And, you know, I mean, I get a lot of looks altogether, but not to my own home. But when I'm with her, obviously they want to try and, you know, work their way in a little bit and try and mess things up.
Yeah.
And then when I go back the next day or something and see those same people, it's a totally different world.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, what do you think? Do you think women just do that just to mess somebody's situation up?
Yeah, of course. I believe that. I don't know why people seem to just want somebody when they're like
when they're happy.
To be a freaking homewrecker or something.
Yeah. So basically, when they see people happy, they want to try and mess things up or say I'm better than you, right?
I don't see what's so attractive about somebody who's in a relationship.
Well, let me tell you this. Dude, we all have that one family member that we just mm-hmm. you see him at all the parties.
It used to be me.
Okay. And then you hear somewhere down the road that he's been cheating or she's been cheating. And everyone's like, what?
Yeah.
They go to church.
Yeah. And they're the ones that cheated with him.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. The family members are the worst.
Exactly.
So, I mean, I always figure like this. It's like, I don't know. It seems like, I really forgot what I was about to say. But I was about to put my foot in my mouth here, I think. But, no. Honestly, I think if you see people happy, I mean, leave them alone. You know what I mean? I mean, just to me, it was always better, it seemed, if they were taken. I mean, I don't mean to be like that, but obviously a lot of women come over to you and they just, when they're taken, there's no responsibility there for the other side. Okay, there's no, what am I talking about? There's no commitment, there's none of that stuff. It's basically, let's go have fun and you're missing what you're missing and we'll try and give it to each other and that's the way it is. You know, and of course that's wrong. I mean, obviously we know that now. I mean, I'm a little more mature, but at that point in time, I didn't want a relationship. I didn't want to settle down. I didn't want any of that. And if you get with a single girl, obviously they're gonna want that. They're gonna want that. And then I've kind of realized that if you establish your ground rules or basically what you are and what you're looking for, look at her rolling her eyes right there.
Because I'm just like, that doesn't make any sense. It's like you're contradicting yourself. You're not wanting to commit yourself, so you get with somebody who's in a relationship, but yet you're committing yourself to whoever you're with, obviously, because you're in a relationship as well. It's like stupidly.
Well, I'm talking about before I get in a relationship. You know, if I'm not in a relationship, then obviously for a long time there, I didn't want to be in a relationship. You know, so I didn't want to meet somebody, and then obviously you're going to end up having sex with that person, and you know, they're going to get this idea and this image built up that, oh, now we're going to go and ride horses off in the sunset. I didn't want that for a long time. Obviously now, I mean, I'm almost just about ready for that again. But
I still...
Well, I
horses? No,
yeah, horses. Why not? You know, castles.
I don't like horses.
Well, I think. I mean, it's funny when I see a lot of pretty girls, and for some reason, all pretty girls are always single. They really are. For some reason,
not for long.
They're single, and you start dating them a little bit.
Every week.
And this is the truth about some of the girls that I dated that were very beautiful. After 2-3 weeks of dating them, I finally realized why they were single, and they were all screwed up somehow, some way.
Those are the best kind, aren't they?
Yes and no. But it goes to show that I just think relationships in general are very – it's just a dysfunctional, very world. It's not like the 80s where, right. You know, you had to cherish your wife that you had. Now you got to cherish your girlfriends and the 7 girls that, you know, you're dating and keep rolling.
Yeah. I tell you no doubt about it. And, you know, I tell you what another thing is that they always put – everybody always puts their best face on. Let's not forget that. I mean – if you don't live with somebody, then you really don't know what that person is always about 100%, okay? They're going to if they glorify you or they put you on a pedestal or they find something about you that they want or they like, they're going to put their best face forward every time. You know, once you actually get to know that person a little bit deeper and a little bit more and actually spend some time with them, like living, like waking up with them, going to sleep with them, you know, not just having sex with them, you know what I mean? So that's when you find out who they really are, okay? And sometimes it's different than they really are.
I agree. I tell everybody I date, if we could go through 1 year, and we are going to argue, and if we can make it that 1 year, then I'll put that relationship title on.
Yeah.
I dated a girl years ago, my younger days, and we were just talking. We didn't even really go out on our date. But then she started asking me for some money. Hey, I'm short my car payment, and hey, do you mind if I move in? I was like, well, wait a minute, pump your brakes.
Mm-hmm.
Like, no. And I think you know, I tell all my buddies, date the girl for a while, man. Don't just – believe me. My biggest thing right now, and I'm telling you, listeners, if you're going to date a girl, make sure she has good credit. Because and that's the truth. Because later on, you're going to fall in love with this girl. You're going to go get an apartment, and you're going to find out that she owes 40 grand.
Yeah.
And now guess what? That 40 grand, that's now your debt.
Yes, it is. I tell you what, or you could be like – or you could be like her.
Right? She, yeah. Right.
What if you owe 500 grand?
Vice versa.
You know,
she's there with me, and I owe 500.
Do a credit check. I dated a girl, and I got to get going right now because I know you guys are doing your show. But I dated a girl, and we got pulled over, and I actually liked her.
Uh-huh.
I dated her for 3 months. We get pulled over, and she goes, "I got to tell you something."
I got a warrant.
And I'm looking at her, right? And this girl goes to church. She goes, "I got a warrant." He goes, "You got a warrant for what?" She goes, I didn't want to tell you, but I got a few domestic violence charges on me. Uh-huh. So that immediately.
And I'm holding this bag. Can you hoop it?
Exactly. So, and it's funny because the cop pulls me out and he's talking to me and he goes, hey, man, I just letting you know that girl that you're talking to, we're taking her in. I go, well, good. And he goes, dude, why are you with her, man? She's really messed up.
See, that's
I never knew that.
Well, you sure did in the sheets.
Well, now I do.
You know. Hey, Anthony, you got to cut out?
Yeah, I got to go, man. I want to thank you for having me on.
Hey, thanks for spending time with us. Don't forget to let them know your show.
Yeah, I'm on prior to this from 6 to 7 with Wicked Wednesdays. We play old school and house and all
Rock
that.
Rocking the house.
Yeah, and I've been trying to come on with this guy for a while, and we finally made it happen. I really appreciate you guys.
Hey,
and
thank you.
Much success in the world.
Yes, sir.
And remember, do a credit check.
Yeah, we'll be doing this again. All right, brother. Have a great night.
You too. Thank you.
All right. So how you doing there, dear?
I'm good. How are you?
Are we doing credit checks right now?
Bye.
I don't think so. I think yours is better than mine.
Nah, probably not. But.
Yeah, who knows? Hey, listen. Credit is bad. Speaking of credit checks, you know what I heard? And let me go ahead and pull this up here. So I was looking around, right? You know, I mess around on the internet a little bit and, you know, do a little internet surfing, you could say. Because I'm pretty paranoid and lurky.
No.
Yes. No, not me. So I come across, you know, I put my name in there. I'm sure everybody puts their names in there sometimes. And, you know, sometimes I go by Jason, sometimes I go by Michael. But, you know, today I went by Jason, and I tell you what. I pull up, and I'm starting to do a little bit of picture stuff and, you know, some writing and, you know, some books and everything like that. And come to find out, there's somebody in Australia that I guess has the exact same, you know, same age as me, same name, almost looks just like me. And he just happens to have a Photoshop and a bookshop and basically almost the same thing I got. How was that? Have you ever heard of that?
No.
I mean, I know it's from down under, and we're supposed to have twins and everything like that, but I didn't know that my twins were right really down under.
Down under.
I mean, are we going to throw another shrimp on the barbie for me, or what's going on?
Crikey.
Crikey. Crocodile Dundee. Remember that stuff? That's actually not Crocodile Dundee, but that's where it first started.
Okay.
Okay. So let's get back to, because this has really got me a little bit heated, okay? Because I noticed a lot of things around me. You know, and I hate to feel this way. You know, I don't want to be a jealous individual, and I'm really not. And I'm really not an envious person. You know, I mean, I'm all about positivity, and I'm really all about everybody really doing well for themselves, you know, and helping their fellow person along as well. But in my opinion, it has to come with some sort of honor and integrity, okay? You know, we've all done a lot of things in our past, me included, and sometimes even in the present, I try not to do as much, but listen, so we've all done some things that we maybe, you know, don't feel the greatest about, or we know isn't the rightest thing, the best thing for us to do, okay? We don't set a good example on certain things that we do. But
we're human.
We are human.
And we all make mistakes.
Yeah, some of us are. Some of us aren't.
As long as you learn from them.
Yes, but here's the thing. The people that are out there making mistakes, and I've never heard of these people, okay? They all seem to have some of my relatives' last names. All right, and I don't really know if they're actually real or not real.
Like,
well, it's got ABN, right? So I think that stands for Australian Business Network or something like that, or number, okay? So come to find out, I guess you can have a social security number here, and you can also have an ABN number there. And as long as they don't commingle, you're basically two separate people living two different lives.
What do you mean commingle?
As long as you don't use your, let's say you have a Bank of America account here, right? So as long as you don't apply for a Bank of America account there, you know, I guess they're just trying to stay under the radar. So would that be like identity theft or fraud or what the heck is that?
That sounds like a headache.
That sounds like a nightmare. Okay.
Yeah.
And why would you want to do that to me? Huh? I mean, what is that what's going on? Because I'm going to find out. All right. And I don't really want to find out. You know, because God sees all, ladies and gentlemen. And if that's not who you believe in, or you believe in a higher power, well, that's just what it is. All right. And that higher power, because there is one creator. And the creator is not like ugly like that. All right? Especially to one of his positive people. You know, it took me a while to get to this point. You know, yeah, I wasn't always positive. Let's trust and believe that.
I believe it.
Yes, but I've become a more rounded individual. At least I try to be.
Yes. Right?
You know, because I want people to do well. I want people to do good. I don't want people to get cheated. Especially not me. Okay? And sometimes I don't pay attention to stuff on myself, you know, because I kind of neglect myself. Maybe because I think about other people first a lot of times, and maybe not. But bottom line is, I sometimes put myself on the back burner a lot, okay? And to take advantage of that is, to me, is one of the worst things you could do.
Yeah, most definitely.
You know, if somebody extends their hand to you, you don't shake their hand and then, you know, spit on them as soon as they turn around.
Yeah.
To me, that's coward, okay? If you don't want somebody's help, or if you have some malicious intent, or you just don't like that person, you don't shake their hand. All right, plain and simple. You know, if you got a problem with somebody, you declare that problem right then and there. You don't go stewing on it and let it build up and build up, and next thing you know, you have this huge situation where you have two parties that are going to have to react. And as you know, I mean, none of us want to react in a way that it's going to escalate to. Okay, I don't want to go back to jail. I'm sure whoever else doesn't want to go anywhere. So what do you want to do that? Huh? The energy you're spending on all this stuff, do it yourself. Right, put your own name on there. And if you can't put your own name on there, then fix your name. You know, because if you can't look at yourself in the mirror and know what your name is, then hey, you got a problem, bud.
Yeah.
Okay? So don't go jumping off of my whatever it is. Do your own stuff. All right? J-Sun, J-Store, all that good stuff. All right? So ABNs, I don't know what's going on there, but I'm going to have to take a little trip down to Australia.
Hey there.
You want to come?
I want to see some kangaroos.
Kangaroos are cool. Crocodiles, all that good stuff. Don't go out back.
No, not crocodiles.
No, why not? No?
What are we talking about?
We'll go to Australia.
Okay.
Hey, if anyone wants to support our Australia trip, please give me a call. All right, phone number is 888-909-1050. Also, 909-888-5222. And what are we on the radio? What numbers?
106.5 FM, right. 102.3 FM, and 1050 AM.
Yep, and you can also catch us on kcaaradio.com. And I believe you can catch us on Ustream and YouTube after this as well. So remember, it's going to be life, space, camera, action. All right, and you can also email me, you know, lifecameraaction923@gmail.com. You know, because I'd love to go to Australia.
Yeah, and it's life, L-I-F-E.
Like, how did I get life? L-I-F-E. Okay, follow me around taking pictures of my life.
What?
Why you want to do, what does game say? Why you want to mess my life? I like that song. That was an older one.
What song?
Yeah, you know, the want to mess around with my life. I don't know what it is. I'll have to the producer. I'm not a very good singer. She's not like her. She's the singer in the family here.
Thanks.
Yes. See, we're trying to get her out there, guys. So she's doing a darn good job. We're just, you know, we got a couple little bumps in the road, both of us here. And, yeah, sometimes life isn't so easy. You know, life throws curveballs. And a lot of times they give us tests, and they really want to see what our tenacity, what our desire is. Okay? So you'll see the finish line right there. You know what I mean? And you're running. You're like, oh, there it is. Oh, man, I see it. And then all of a sudden it just keeps getting further and further and further away. Next thing you know, a big gust of wind starts pushing you backwards a little bit. The next thing you know, maybe your shoe came untied, you know, and you're like, dang, look at that. Or some salt from your sweat got in your eye, and you're like, dang, I can't see now. Okay? It happens. I mean, I tell you what, when I used to run, it was a pain in the butt, especially when there was a little sun, and it would hit that sweat, and boom, right in your eye.
Sweat a lot.
Oh, I sweat a lot today.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, buddy.
Yeah, you did.
Yes, we definitely did. See, bruises and everything, because, you know, I'm beat up now.
Great workout.
Yes, great workout. I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen out there, you know, we're talking about all this stuff. That has got to be one of the best workouts, I think, for you. You know, I mean, they try to say that, this and that, but you find somebody that you care about, right? That you love, right? And what you do is you embrace with that person, you become one with that person, you kind of bond, and you know, your weirdness and your not weirdness and your, you know, niceness, sweetness, whatever it is, you know, and it's just you two there, and it's really good, you know. To me, it makes your relationship just that much stronger. You know, it kind of cuts all the BS out of there, you know.
Yeah.
Especially when there's a lot of BS, you know. I don't like that.
No.
You know, can't we just be happy? I mean, that's what we're here for. That's what I'm here for, right?
Amen.
Yeah. So, what should we talk about? I think we get back to my book.
Sure.
So, once again, we got me. It says I am. Okay. Because what you need to believe is this: you are somebody. What does your song say? You are somebody. No.
I am
somebody. Okay, because you are. Your voice matters. Everything about you matters. All right, you're not just here because, I don't know, two people decided, oh, I messed up and had a baby. No. Hey, that's the good part about it. The good part is they give the world an excuse for you to be born. Okay? You were meant to come here, period. No matter what. I don't care if your mother was raped, if it was a fluke, if it was whatever it was.
I mean, we do care. We don't condone any of that.
Listen, of course we don't condone that. I don't condone that at all. And I think all those that do that, they need to be put in a different situation. Okay? So, obviously, I think that in reality, instead of having all these police, I think that if somebody gets convicted of that situation, I think they maybe get a hand cut off. First time. And then I think the second time, guess what else gets cut off?
A foot.
No, I'm thinking something more a little bit in the middle of their body. Because they can live without, I think, with, what do they call testicles? It's called castration, right? I mean, if somebody's committing, if somebody child molests for two times in a row or something, okay, and they're convicted, no doubt about it. I'm, each case can differ, okay? I'm not saying, like, you know, some girl that's 17, it looks like she's 25, and, you know, some guy, like, you know, it's 19 or whatever. I mean, come on, okay, there's variances and degrees to what I'm talking about. But you get some weirdo, all right, and let's say, like, a 9 or 8 year old little girl or a 7 year old little boy, I mean, there's no excuse for that. None at all. That's not acceptable in this society anymore whatsoever. Never was. All right? So those people need to be extinguished. All right? I hate to put it that way. I hate to put it that way, but listen, I don't condone that. That could be my kid. That could be your kid. All right? And if we just sit there and say, oh, well, let's just buy them a house and let's get this and let's get security for them so they don't get hurt. I mean, come on now. That means we're paying for them to live a nice, comfortable life. You know, what about that little 7-year-old kid that's now, you know, 20-something years old and doesn't understand what the heck's going wrong with him or her? What about them? They don't have anybody helping them. They don't have, you know, the government paying their bills. No, you know what they're doing? They're trying to figure something out for themselves, and they're probably spinning in a circle. You know, they can't talk to their parents because their parents are probably embarrassed as well or don't know how to act. They can't talk to their friends because they don't want their friends to know. So what does that little kid do? Huh? Ends up probably turning to drugs, turning on something else. You know, basically it's a life that goes spiraling in the negative direction. All right? Now, not all of them. All right? There's always a couple exceptions to the rules. But, you know, you kids out there, I mean, I'm with you. Give me a call, all right? If you ever got a problem or you ever have something to talk about or you just don't know what to do or how to feel and you don't want maybe your parents or anything to hear you or your friends, call me. All right? I got no problem talking with you. No doubt about it. And I think there's nothing wrong with you at all. You'll never be judged by me whatsoever because that's out of your control, all right? How that person made you feel about yourself or whatever you might be going through now, or maybe it's like a fantasy. It's weird how it works, okay? So call me, all right, because I've experienced a lot of things and I've seen people that have experienced a lot of things, all right? And maybe I can shed some insight to you or just help you get it off your chest, all right? And that number you can reach me is going to be 747-888-2714. I was actually a celebrity head doctor, which, you know, is for psychological. It's kind of psychological, but I'm obviously not a psychiatrist or a psychologist. It's just like a talk line. All right. But if you do have a situation like that and you're just lost and you don't know who to talk to, I mean, I'm not going to charge you. All right. You just call me. I mean, I'm a person just like you. You know what I mean? Obviously, yeah, I got to pay my bills. I mean, I got to eat too. I got to do something because, I mean, I'm only getting older and I got a pretty hot girlfriend here. All right. So I don't want all these other dudes like scooping her up with all these fancy cars and all this other stuff. So, you know, obviously, I got to make a living somehow. But if you're in need like that, I don't care about money. Okay, money can go away. I really don't care. I care about you as people more than that. All right. And if you're suffering or you're having a hard time, you don't know what to do or what to say or who to talk to, you call me. All right. No doubt about it. I'm there. All right.
Yeah, and just keep in mind, y'all. You know, no matter what you're going through in life, like, no matter what it is, what situation you're in, just always remember you're not alone.
You're not alone, and tomorrow is always a new day. All right, sometimes I go to sleep and I'm real depressed. And it doesn't happen very often. You know, I'm usually in a pretty positive mood. No, but every, like, maybe, I think men have periods, like, every once every six weeks,
proven,
right?
Proven fact that men have a period.
Yeah, so once every 6 weeks, I get kind of, you know, there's about a two-day period where I'm just, man, I'm just, everything's going, it's just nothing. Even if the sun's shining out, I'm just like, you know, ugh.
Yeah.
Even waking up next to you, I'm still like, I don't want to talk to nobody. I don't want to deal with anything. And I'm just doom and gloom. You know, and sometimes it gets pretty intense. You know what I mean? It's hard to realize and rationalize in your head, especially when you're younger and it's just happening to you. All right, I've been doing this for a while. So remember, tomorrow is always a new day. Okay? It always is the darkest before the light. Okay? So which means that it might be really bad for you right now. All right? You might feel really bad, but it's a test. Okay? It's a test to see your strength as a person. All right. If you're gonna throw in the towel, if you're gonna keep pushing, all right. You know, tell you what, go grab a book and just sit there and read or do nothing. Go in the room and just draw on yourself or just drool on yourself. Whatever you need to do. That's what I do.
Listen to that song, "Keep Your Head Up" by Andy Grammer.
Yeah, or you know,
it's
or
a
even
great song.
I Believe I Can Fly.
Yeah, that's a good one. But I like that "Keep Your Head Up" one.
Keep your head up. Or if you don't feel like even doing that, because sometimes I don't want to listen to anything. I don't want to hear anything. I don't want to see anything. I'm just like, you know, just close the door and just, like I said. drool on yourself for a while.
Don't do that.
Then you wake up the next day and you feel fresh. You know what I mean? You feel good. Mm-hmm. You know, maybe take a shower. You know, that's always good.
To remember sometimes, but you got to keep your head up. Jordan loves that song.
Well, that's a good song. Yeah, we need more positive. I like positivity. You know what I mean? Let's just try and remember this. Try and influence the person next to you. Or maybe not the person next to you because, hey, I'd love to influence you, but, you know, let's say you know somebody and you just see them and they're having a bad day. You know, a lot of times what we used to do is, oh, I don't want to look at that guy. I mean, he looks kind of scary. I don't know, you know, who knows what's going on with him. You know, let's just acknowledge these people. Say, if you're worried and he looks kind of crazy, you know, just for me to say, hey, how you doing, man? I hope you're okay. And just keep stepping. You know, just that little acknowledgement makes people smile a little bit.
Yeah, it does.
Makes me smile.
Smile goes a long ways. Yeah. Smiles for days.
It's been a while since we've seen you smile.
Smile. It looks good on y'all.
I like that expression.
Yep, me too.
That's a good one. I think that I have that written under my table, right?
Yeah.
My little badass little girl hairs, huh? Little tiger hair.
It's just a good, it's a positive reminder.
It's a good mantra.
Whenever you're laying on the floor looking up at the table, you can just.
It's a great mantra, okay? Yep. Because you know what? She's right. Smile definitely looks good on you. And you have the choice to smile or frown. And you know what they say is your face is going to freeze on you one day if you keep doing that. That's what my grandfather used to always tell me.
Yeah, I was told the same thing.
Yeah, I think it's a standard thing they tell us, you know.
Jordan kept telling me last weekend when I was with him. He said, Mommy, turn that frown upside down.
That's
right. I wasn't frowning, but I'm like, okay.
Well, maybe you were. I mean, things get hard out there. I mean, you know, here's the thing. A lot of us out here, okay, we don't have people we can ask, all right, advice from, really. Or we can ask them, but we just don't trust them. I mean, I tell you what, I've asked people for advice my whole life, and you know what? They've always led me to a point to where they don't feel like as if they're getting over power. Who knows what it is? I don't know. I mean, everyone seems to be in this competition with everybody else, and you know, forget your competitions. You know, I'm done with all that. You know, I'm just worried about me being happy, my kids being happy. I'm worried about you being happy. All right? I don't want to hear about this competition. I don't care if you got a car. I don't care if you got this or that. I mean, good whoop-de-doo. You know, I've had cars. I've had all that good stuff. You have them now? Well, not so really. Not so really. But, you know, hey, I'm happy. And I'm a little more content. You know what I mean? I'm at peace a little more. You know, I've come to finally realize, you know, that people are more important than money.
Most definitely. I realized that a long time ago.
That's because you're just too smart, girl.
I'm not too smart.
No, but
there's no such thing as too smart.
No, but that part of life you've already experienced. You've already adapted from. You already learned. You've already evolved from, let's say.
Okay? Yeah.
Maybe that's what you're here to help me evolve to. Maybe not that part, but maybe some other parts, you know? And I think that you got to realize that every encounter you come into, okay, is for a reason. Okay, people aren't just there because of a chance, all right? I know we like to think, oh, hey, guess what? I mean, that just met this person. I'm just so cool. I used to think that, hey, I got this person, that person. I just met all these cool people. I mean, I was always little celebrities and stuff. I'm just the coolest there is, you know what I mean? Yeah, but it's BS. All right. Everything happens for a reason. And when you look back and reflect on your life, because you definitely have to reflect. All right. If you don't reflect, you're not going to grow. You're not going to learn from what the situation was. All right. You might encounter something and make the right decision. Okay. Which you're supposed to hopefully make the right decision. And if you don't, you're going to come back around. You're going to catch that deja vu at the time when you're supposed to change up. Like yesterday. All right. We're sitting at my house. And, you know, of course, I'm going to, you know, probably egotistical, jealous kind of mood or whatever.
He's
whatever.
Butthead.
Yeah, butthead. I mean, whatever might have made me. Yeah, you know, my life doesn't always go great, you guys. All right, I mean, I try to pretend it does, but yeah, nobody does. So sometimes I'm feeling a little down about myself. You know, I got about 10, 15 people telling me this and that and this about myself. So sometimes, you know, it adds up on us. You know, and then I see this beautiful thing coming out, and I'm just like, man, how could she like somebody like me? You know, and so. Part of me wants to make, you know, wants me to pretend like, I don't know what it is, but I act like a butt. So I try to get out of the situation. I try to just back off because, you know, I don't want to get hurt. And really, she's not trying to hurt me at all. It's just me just not being confident enough. All right? And that's got to change. So we're at my house and we're relaxing and stuff. And, you know, she's like, oh, can you give me a hug and all this stuff? And, you know, part of me is like, you know, psh, I want to do that stuff. You know, I'm too cool for this and everything. And even though I'm not.
Too cool.
Well, even though I'm not. You know what I mean? And how are you too cool to do that? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So then I come to a point where I was like, wow, you know, I've been here before. I even told her that. I said, this is, well, I've been here. Okay? And I've come to realize that when you feel like you've been somewhere before, that means that you didn't learn the first time what you were supposed to do, or the second, or the third, or the fourth time, what you were supposed to do. All right, you've now come to a point where now you're at that test again. That's why it's called deja vu, because you've been there before. All right, but last time you made the wrong choice. So what you need to do, and what I did, is I figured out, wait, what did I do last time? Because my basic instinct was like, you know what, I'm not giving her a hug. Let her just want me to give her a hug, and she can just, whatever. You know, which you know darn well, as soon as she leaves, I'm going to be sad as hell, and I'll be like, hey, come on back here. You know what I mean? So, and that's what I remembered I did last time. Okay? So I didn't do that this time. And I gave her a hug and kiss, and, you know, and everything kind of worked out for the best, I think. She's still here, right? Yeah. So recognize the signs when they come, all right? Because you'll know it. I didn't know it the first 50 times. You know, I'm sure I've been battling this one for a long time. Not with her, but I mean, you know, she's been great. She, you know, but I've been battling this for a long time. And I finally became present of the action, right? And the action was put that pride aside, all right? Okay, yeah, whoop-de-doo. We all know I could try and stand alone and this and that and everything else. And I can do everything by myself. And, I want to do everything by myself. And nobody can help me and nobody can tell me anything because I know everything. Okay, but when it comes to love, you know, I mean, sometimes you just drop that in the drop that ego at the door.
Like that song, last night, tried to call. What do you say? My pride wouldn't let me dial.
Pride wouldn't let me dial. It's happened to me. I even drove by her house yesterday. Didn't want to call. You know, I couldn't do that.
Nice stalk you all the time.
I like that though.
I won't go knock at your door either.
No, I get a little secret admirer notes.
Yeah,
I like that.
I've done that before.
I know you did. I like that. Uh-huh. And that was a long time ago, but...
It wasn't that long ago.
Not long ago. I mean, it was like 4 months ago, and then we were... My problem is I got to quit distance myself, you know? I got to learn how to just stick it in there no matter what. Okay, because me... Listen, my first goal when it comes to relationships is... I'm not used to those, which that's no excuse, all right? But I want to jump out. I want to bounce as fast as I can if something's not going right, because I figure this is something you choose to do. All right, relationships are by choice, right? It's not that you have to do it. It's by choice. And do I want to choose to, and then I equate current relationships as possibly how previous ones were. And do I want to have that same outcome again? No way. But see, part of the outcome was my fault too.
And so, I don't believe you could have the same outcome with somebody else. Everybody's different.
Everybody is different. Everybody reacts differently. And plus, you know what? I'm different. So I'm consciously
different.
To make a difference of myself, you know. So, am I gonna make those same mistakes again? I mean, I hope not. I mean,
pull up to the scene. What am I stealing?
Seal the missing. Is that two chains? Two chains. I only got one chain right now.
I don't have any.
Chains. Yeah, you got any chains? Yeah, you do.
Two rings.
Two rings, some tattoos, and some yummy stuff. Yeah. Sticker bars. Hey, how's the Snickers?
Snickers are great.
We like Snickers. Especially with the... All right. So, back to... what else are we going to... Oh, you know what I want to talk about? Is what's going on with this Ariana Grande thing? Because that's important, you guys. All right? And
yeah.
I'm really disappointed because I really didn't pay too much attention to what was going on or what was happening. But we were driving my daughter to school today. And she said, you know what's going on with Ariana Grande? And I said, no. I mean, I know her. I like her song, you know, Skin on Skin, all that good stuff. You know, Dangerous. That's a good one.
Shout out to Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande, you know? Plus Big Sean used to talk about it when they used to go together, you know?
Shout out to Big Sean.
Finally famous. So.
Yeah.
You know, so, but I'm looking here, and it looks like she was having a concert in Manchester, right? And a suicide attack left 22 dead and 59 injured, with many of those in life-threatening condition. What's up with that, you guys? I mean, come on. What is this really what it's about? I mean, you want to go kill a bunch of little kids? They're just trying to have a good time? I mean, you were little kids once. I mean, come on. Do you want your... I mean, I know life was hard for people in other parts of this country and world and all that other good stuff. You know, but listen. You can make a difference. You don't need to be a... You don't need to be a reason. Don't be the reason. You know, be the cause. Be the effect of a change. All right. I know if you've had tough times, and let's say your family got hurt, all right, or killed, or blown up, and maybe you were 3-4 years old and had to survive for yourself. I mean, of course you're going to be hostile. You're going to be angry. You don't want vengeance. You want to feel. You're gonna feel as if the world didn't do you right. Didn't give you the chance that everybody else had. Why don't you voice that? Huh? I mean, why don't you instead of grabbing a bomb and trying to blow somebody up to make them feel the same way you do? Why don't you voice how you're feeling and why we should change and how we can change? Do that. Be a positive. I mean, I'll have you on here. You know, tell your story. Tell it. I mean, we can all listen. All of us have had, maybe not all of us, but a good chunk of us, me included, have had things happen in our lives where I've wanted to do the same thing. I've wanted to slip and I wanted to do things, and listen, I've had to atone for some of the things that I've done. But now it's a time where we understand we're adults now, okay? And now it's time to realize that those things happen and those were out of our control. All right? And how can we do something about it? We could voice our opinion. We could fix it. All right? I mean, what about the generation after you? What about the generation after them? You know, your great-great-grandkids. Don't you want them to have a beautiful, peaceful environment to live in? Huh? To learn from the hardship that you had to endure because some idiots didn't know what they, you know, had some pissing contest with each other? You know, I can't agree with you. You can't agree with me. So I'm going to blow your people up. I mean, come on.
And honestly, it's like if your life is that miserable that it's causing you to want to go and, you know.
Take it on other people?
Like cause harm to other people. Like, don't you really there and stop and think like, well, my life's going to be like 20 times more even miserable after I do this than it is now. Like, I mean, do you want to just continue to live a bad life, or do you want to turn it around and change things for the better?
Yeah, or just imagine how you felt when you found out that happened to you. Why do you want all these kids to feel the same way you did? Huh? I don't want my kids to grow through the same things I did. There's no way, there's no doubt, there's no. That's why I went through what I had to go through, so they don't have to go through that. All right, I've already overcome that obstacle. All right, now they don't have to worry about that. They can go on to their own obstacles. Why do you want to spread that feeling that you got to everybody else? Right? Don't do that. You're better than that. All right? I mean, I'll listen to you. Call us up. 888-909-1050. Or what's that other one?
909-888-5222.
And you know what? If you don't want to talk to me, I got a pretty girl right here. She's willing to talk as well.
Yeah.
You know, we tell you, call us. We'll call. Talk to us. We'll talk back. Trust and believe that.
Indeed.
You know, nobody's going to judge you. Nobody's going to, you know. I got plenty of friends in the Middle East, no doubt about it. I got plenty of friends all over the world, Russia, Syria, what other bad supposed places there are, Iran, Iraq, I mean, Israel. I mean, I got friends from everywhere, okay? And not all of them are bad, and not all of them are trying to kill everybody like supposedly it says, all right? A lot of people are good people, and they just want to be happy, just like us,
yeah.
Just like us. And, of course, they see things on TV, and they see all the stars and celebrities, and you know, they figure, oh, California, L.A., oh, my gosh, that's where all it's the most beautiful in the world. And yes, we do have, obviously, we have a beautiful place to live, no doubt about it. But, I said, everybody goes through the same struggles. You know, it just depends on where you're at. You know, over there, their struggles that affects them the same way our struggles over here affects us. You know, remember that, you guys. I mean, people in other countries, I don't know if you're, obviously, you're not tuning in or listening, but if you are, and I'm sure you have relatives that probably are, you know, let them know that, you know, it's time for us to come together, all right? It's time for us to treat people good, all right? And if you feel bad or you're still going through it, you know, talk to somebody about it. Talk to me about it. Talk to her about it. You know,
yes.
Talk to somebody that's gonna let you get it out. Because it's not your fault. And you shouldn't take it out on the next person, next kid. I mean, come on.
And you also shouldn't keep it bottled up.
Never keep it bottled up. You know, because what's going to happen? Then you're going to get married. You know, you're going to keep it still inside because you're so macho, tough man. You can't cry. You can't shed anything. You can't be vulnerable. Because probably last time you were vulnerable, you lost your parents or something like that. And that's understandable, okay?
I actually think it is very attractive for a man to cry.
Oh, it is?
We
got to pick up some onions on the way home so I can just chop them up, start a little tearing up. I was like, babe, you know, I'm so tired. I don't know what's going on.
I used to love cutting onions just to, like, make my eyes water.
I like eating onions.
Yeah. I never used to like onions. They're pretty good now.
Listen, we all cry, okay? I mean, I cried when my daughter was born. My first kid was born, all right? I cried, you know, I mean, I cried inside a few times, all right? Sometimes you get to a point where it's like that, and it gets bottled up, and you just got to go be by yourself.
I cry all the time.
Well, you need to. It's good.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's how you can release that energy that that's negative. I mean, or that's
unleash the beast.
Or not even as negative. That's that you don't understand. Okay, why did this person do this to me? Why did this happen? I mean, what? How is this possible? Okay, because these are questions that sometimes we don't know yet. Doesn't mean you're not going to ever know, because you're going to eventually find it out. It's in your brain there. You just don't know how to unlock that part. All right, but it all happens because it's for the greater whatever it might be. I want to say good
it's
of
fur.
Humanity.
It's fur.
It's fur. Yeah.
It's fur.
It's fur.
It's on fur.
No fur.
That's the mood. Roof is on fur.
So, but seriously though, all right, everything happens for a reason. I don't want to say it's for a good thing. Obviously, it's not. But maybe you're the reason that happened. All right, maybe you are that voice that needs to come out, so that people stop hurting people. Okay, maybe that's why it happened to you. Have you ever thought of that? Maybe you're going to be the innovator to make peace in certain areas. Maybe imagine that. Huh? You're this big bad person that, you know, lost their family. All right, as a little child. And you're sitting there not knowing what to do. Lost, scared. All right? Maybe you're that voice that needed to come out so people could understand the magnitude of what they're doing. Because what they're doing isn't good. And then we like to all say, it's for this, or, you know, we got to keep these people out, or keep them out, or, you know, we can't be friends with them, or they're trying to kill us, they're trying to hurt us. You know, listen, say, miss me with that. Because I don't see anybody coming up to my house with a gun.
Swear.
You know, I mean, so why am I going to go to their house and blow them up before they even do anything to me? That doesn't seem cool. You know, I don't care. I don't want to protect their poppy field. I mean, let them go do their own thing.
That's pretty ballsy.
But for me to say that?
No, just people just do, like, just...
Take over stuff like
just,
that.
Like, I'm gonna go bomb this place. Like, yeah. Wow.
I mean, who the hell? I mean, who the heck are we?
Like, don't you sit there and like see already what this world is like become, and you're just gonna.
Just imagine if somebody does that to you. All right. I know you like to push this button. You get this power trip, and oh, I'm doing this and all this short talk. But I tell you what happens if somebody takes your kids? Then what?
Somebody's gonna get it if they touch my kid.
Well, then what? You know what I mean? You ever thought about that? We all got kids. Everybody does.
Not everybody.
Well, I mean, most people. But think about that. Okay? Things can always be worked out. Okay? I don't see anybody at the White House with machine guns. Except for our guys.
Knock on wood. How are you doing there?
I'm doing a little better now. I think the roof just dropped out on me.
It was on fur.
It was on fur. So I don't know if I'm getting a little too political with all this stuff. And, you know, we hear about Trump and Russia and all this other stuff. And I don't know. Part of me believes that they're buddies. They're probably having drinks right now. I forgot Trump doesn't drink. Never has.
I mean, honestly, I
how
just...
How do you casino no drink?
I kind of just was like... shout out to Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Oh, no.
You're...
What do you do?
The Terminator. He's a governor. Like, what?
Governator.
How does that happen?
I thought you had to be a United States citizen, but hey, more power to everybody. I tell you what, if the people vote for you, why shouldn't you be it?
Like, most definitely, but.
Listen, I think that there's certain periods of time that are meant for certain things. I mean, Bill Clinton, I mean, we had a surplus, things were good, everybody was happy. I like George Bush too, but he needed to go in there and blow things up, I guess. Obama was good too. I mean, he stabilized a couple things, made a few things happen. You know, gave hope to a whole race of people. You know, realizing that they can do whatever, anything just as good as anybody else, which they should have known anyway. They're just people, just like all of us.
Like J. Cole says, there's no such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Exactly. And you know what? I was just thinking about this. So the difference between color is this. You figure we're all made of matter, right? All right, so that's what it is. We're just like a soul into matter. So do you think that color depends on which part of sand you came from? Because, you know, they have white sand beaches, they have black sand beaches, they have brown sand beaches.
They were made of sand?
Well, I think that's part of what our body is, correct?
I don't know, man. I read some way, like, out of this world stuff. Like, that one time, remember,
they were talking about
we come from this, I guess, dirt and like...
semen? What was it? It was
penis,
dirt.
Like the foreskin.
Donkey stuff.
No, it was like the foreskin or like blood from the like what? I mean, out of penis blood and dirt. Like,
well, you gotta figure this. Maybe that's why our muscles get bigger sometimes.
What muscles?
Our stretch. You know these ones. Ugh. Or maybe this one.
I've got no muscles.
You don't need.
Well, you work out like all the time.
Well, you're heavy. I know. Lifts and use workout. That's darn good.
Really?
Isn't it a great workout? Yes, I love that. Yeah. Let's do. What were they? Chin-ups.
You do chin-ups.
Yes, I do. Now I have my nice little. Yeah, I've worked out for a little while, but now I'm on Coast Street. So, you know, now it's time. I'm just waiting for things to happen. I've got this little book coming. Hope we get some action there. You know, I tell you what, pick it up, you guys. All right, it's going to distribute it to a couple places. Let people check it out. I'm going to, maybe send it to a couple studios and see if maybe they want me to write for some stuff for them. You know, they're pretty busy and probably not, but hey, you got to go for what you want to do.
Yeah.
All right, closed mouths don't get fed. Remember that. All right, so if you want to do something, you go do it. Don't wait for it to come to you because it's not. All right, I mean, it won't. I mean, because don't forget, people don't want the competition. Bottom line. You know, I mean, you get two people in a room or three people and they say, hey, I want to do this and this and this. Well, they're thinking, well, that's my job.
Yeah.
So do they really want to give you their job? I don't think so. So remember, I don't have anybody to ask advice from most of the time. I know she doesn't really have anybody to ask for advice from most of the time. Or not that I would honestly think that they would have my full benefit selflessly in. Okay? Selfishly. Selfishly. I'm coming up with new words all the time. Dramatically.
It's a dramatical.
Dramatical.
Like, what does that even mean?
That's a good word, dramatical.
No, it's really not.
We got the commissioner. Here he is. He's coming up next, you guys. So I hope you stay tuned for him. He's actually a real nice guy. He had me on the show last week, and I got to talk to the councilman or assemblyman. And he had a really good conversation, you know. I mean, that's helping kids and helping people and, you know, getting teachers out there. I mean, they're doing this bill where I guess they're trying to give housing benefits for teachers that come to teach in the San Bernardino area.
Nice.
I think that's awesome. I tell you what, I think they should give them free houses, period. People say, free houses, what? Give them free stuff. Yeah, free houses. Okay.
Best things in life are free.
The thing is, listen, teachers don't make much money. I tell you what, all these homeless people I see on the streets out here too, you can get them working and have them build some houses. Let's give them some houses too.
Like, y'all should watch that movie, Freedom Riders. That's a great great movie. It's like kind of an example like that. So this teacher goes out of her way and purchases her own stuff for this not very fortunate school, you know. And it's,
that's the way to go.
Yeah.
Listen, we love our teachers. Teachers need to get paid more than entertainers.
We all need to just care about each other.
Care about each other, care about the future, care about kids.
Hug a tree.
All keep an eye out for each other. Say hi to somebody. Be nice. Smile. Don't forget, I am MJM 1975.
Somebody.
Somebody. Bye-bye.
Later, guys. Your friends that stand around you watch you crumble.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.